trends in record time, often within weeks of a new trend appearing, which is wild because nowadays with social media, I mean, it happens literally in an instant. And when we think of fast fashion,
toxic dyes and
or methods, it's used to meet demand for rapid turnover. I want you to consider this. So, the fashion industry is estimated to account for 10% of global carbon emissions. To put that in perspective, that's more than the emissions from all international flights and maritime shipped combined. So, the sheer scale of its impact is staggering. The fast fashion model itself exacerbates the problem because trends change so quickly. Companies are constantly churning out new products to keep up with demand. This rapid turnover means clothes are produced at a breakneck pace, often with shorter lifespans. As a result, the production cycle repeats endlessly, as you can imagine, creating a loop of increased energy used, emissions, and waste. It's a system designed for speed, but that speed comes at a steep environmental cost. Now, let's talk about where all of those items go once we're done with them. Spoiler alert, most of these items don't get a second life. They end up in the trash, just to be completely honest, fueling a growing crisis of textile waste. So, there is a staggering statistic that I was able to find that every second, the equivalent of one garbage truck full of textiles is either sent to a landfill or burned, often after being worn just a handful of times. According to my research, recycling doesn't offer much relief either. Only 15% of clothing is recycled, and even when it is, it's usually not turned back into new fabric. Instead, it's often downcycled into products like insulation or cleaning cloths, which eventually still end up as waste. The technology to effectively recycle textiles into new clothing is limited, and the sheer volume of discarded garments definitely overwhelms the system. Oh, the issue doesn't stop at landfills. In wealthier countries, fast fashion waste is frequently exported to developing nations, where it creates an even heavier burden. Countries in Africa and Asia receive massive shipments of secondhand clothing, much of which is unusable due to the poor quality. These garments often overwhelm local waste systems, creating environmental and social challenges for communities that were never part of the fast fashion equation. So I did find the Ghana, sorry if I mispronounce it, it's Ghana's Kiantamanto market. It's a great example. It's one of the largest secondhand clothing markets in the world, processing millions of items every week. While some clothing is repurposed or sold, a significant portion is so damaged and so low quality that it simply can't be reused. So these unusable items pile up, as you can imagine, in enormous heaps, clogging up waterways, polluting land, and adding to a growing waste crisis. As you can imagine, it doesn't stop at the ecosystems. It's also a deeply human issue for the millions of people who depend on the rivers for drinking, cooking, and bathing. The contamination poses a serious health risk. These vibrant hues might look striking in photographs, but they tell a story of water that is no longer safe to use. Just to really put it in perspective, these textile factories release extremely toxic fumes, contributing to air pollution in the surrounding areas. This exposure can cause respiratory problems like asthma, chronic bronchitis for those living nearby. Fast fashion doesn't affect everyone equally. It disproportionately impacts low-income communities, often in developing countries where factory workers and residents bear the brunt of pollution. I bet you're wondering, what can we do about the environmental destruction caused by fast fashion? While the problem can feel overwhelming, trust me, I was looking into it, I was like, wow, there are some steps we can take, both as individuals. I definitely want to start with consumer choices, and the simplest and most effective action that we can take is to buy less. That's something that I really have worked on, and it's something that I feel like we all need to work on, is just consuming less instead of chasing those constant, ever-changing trends. Sure.